start the engine, turn the heater to maximum, and then turn off the engine. Never take the radiator cap off when it's hot. The system's under pressure and you could be scalded by steam. Make sure the engine is cool and the radiator cap is cool, and then remove it. The radiator drain plug is on the passenger side. This is the hole where the coolant will drip out, and up here is the radiator drain plug. This is what the coolant drain plug looks like. Here you can see the coolant drain outlet underneath the coolant drain plug. This is looking up from the bottom of the car. You can see the coolant drain outlet is the black circle near the middle of the picture. You can fit a 7mm inner diameter tube around the coolant drain outlet to drain your coolant. You should be able to turn it with your fingers, but mine's a little tight in there, so I'm going to use a 22mm socket to get it started. Now you only have to loosen it part way to get the coolant to start flowing. If you don't use tubing, the coolant is going to cause a mess. Then just tighten it up finger tight. This coolant still looks fairly blue, so I'm not going to flush the coolant out, I'm just going to replace it. This is what the new coolant looks like, basically the same as the used coolant. Remove the front passenger wheel to gain access to the engine block drain. The engine block drain plug is here. I used a 12mm deep socket and the ratchet ran into the car a little bit, so a regular socket might work better. You can see 3.5 feet of tubing was just about right. It's all done draining, so we have to tighten it up. You want to tighten it up to 7.4 foot-pounds. It's not much. Next, you want to locate your coolant reservoir, which is right here. It might be a little stuck. You might need to use two hands to get it out. This is the boss that fits into a slot to hold it in place. You just unscrew this cap so you can empty the remaining coolant in the reservoir. Here's the cap and the hose that goes inside the bottle. I recommend using Honda coolant. This is specially designed to prevent corrosion of the aluminum system. I was able to add 1 gallon, 2 quarts, and 13 ounces. There are 10 steps to bleeding the air from the cooling system and ensuring the cooling system is working properly. We'll go over some of those steps so you know what to do. The first step is to set the heat to maximum and then rev the engine at 1500 RPMs until the radiator fan comes on at least twice to make sure the thermostat is open. There are two fans, one here and one here. There's one fan. There's a second fan. Make sure the heat is set to maximum. Start the engine. And rev the engine to 1500 RPM until the radiator fans come on twice. You can't hear the fans turn on and off over the sound of the engine, but what you're waiting for is for the thermostat to open. To check if the thermostat is open, feel the upper radiator hose. It should be hot, since the thermostat will allow hot coolant to flow into the radiator. Make sure the engine temperature doesn't go much above halfway. An air bubble near the engine temperature sensor could cause the temperature to spike momentarily. If the engine temperature does remain high, however, shut down the engine and wait for it to cool before proceeding. I revved my engine for 5 minutes for step one. You can see we can add some more coolant now. Now we want to set the temperature to the maximum cool. Start the engine. Then hold the RPMs at 1500 for 5 minutes. Turn off the car. We can maybe add a little bit more coolant. Now you've completed steps 1 and 2. Keep going with steps 3, 4, 5, and 6 until you don't need to add any more coolant. Now we'll continue on with steps 7 to 9. Before we get started, measure the interior temperature at the rear heat vents. The interior temperature is 65 degrees Fahrenheit. Now install the cap loosely. If you turn it all the way here, it's closed, so you can kind of feel where it is. It's halfway about. Set to maximum cool for this final run. Start the engine. 2500 RPM for 1 minute. Select the high heat mode in the rear controller. I'm in the back seat now. The airflow temperature is 106 degrees. Next, you want to check the airflow temperature versus the standard line. If you're below the standard line, you have to repeat steps 4 and 5 several more times. We're at 65 degrees and 106 degrees, which is just below the standard line, so we have to repeat the process. Finally, check to see if you can hear water flowing near the rear heater. If you can hear water flowing, repeat steps 4 and 5. I don't hear any water flowing. Turn off the car. Close the cap all the way. Now I took my coolant bottle out so we can look at things a little more clearly, but you can leave yours in place. The coolant bottle has a minimum and maximum line marked on there. We're going to fill it up to the max. Now we're going to add 14 additional ounces to account for the coolant volume shrinkage when the coolant cools. This is how full your bottle should be. Now that the coolant's cooled down, you can see we're still above the max by a little bit. So pour off that extra and get back down to the max.